Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to set up path for an object in Salesforce Lightning experience. Before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can open my channel on YouTube and go to playlists. So there you can find various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages. Now coming on to the topic. So here you can see I have already opened a record of opportunity. So if you see this this bar, progressive bar, so this is basically a path available on a particular record related to an object. So if I click here and go to edit page, so now I'm going to tell you how you can place this path on your record page. So at left hand side, you can search for path. So here you can see it is available. So let's say if I remove it from here, I deleted that component. Now here you can see I searched this path and I am dragging and dropping it here. So you can see it is available. So if this is not available on your record page, so you can drag and drop it so that it will be available. And at right hand side, all the options related to path will be available. So before going in the detail of this path, I'm going here. So you can see here only 5 fields are visible. So this path is by default showing stage pick list of opportunity, right? So if I open the record type of that record, so this record, let's say I'm clicking on back. So check the record type first so that we can identify the sales process that is related to that record type. So here you can see I have a Salesforce inspector, so through which I can identify its record type. So it is opportunity demo one. So here you can see this record type is available and it is having this sales process. So I'm opening this sales process demo one. So in this sales process, I have selected certain fields. Those will be available as stage pick list values on that record type. And that stage pick list values will be used for the path. So here you can see all these values are selected. So those are displayed here in the path section, right? So these are related to stage pick list. So if I go to detail, so from here you can also verify them. So here you can see stages needs select needs analysis. So this is by default selected here. And if I click here, so first is prospecting. So you can see this one is prospecting, then ID, decision maker. So it is available here. Then proposal, then closed won and closed lost are not shown here. Only closed is available. And then here you can click mark stage as complete. So if you want to click that stage, you can, if you want to complete that stage, you can click here so that it will be marked as complete and your, next stage will be available. So this way stage pick list is used here as path. Now I'm going to tell you how you can set up this path so that you can add more features. So by default, in case of opportunity, stage pick list is used for this path, but now you will see we can choose any other pick list field as well. So click on this setup path. So path setting will be opened. So here you can click on enable so that it will be available. You can click new path. So here, let's say I'm choosing opportunity path as name. Then from here, I need to choose the object. Then here it will show all available record types. So for one record type, you can create only one path. And here you can see all pick lists are available. So you can choose any one of them, whichever you want to use as path. So I'm choosing stage as of now. Clicking on next. So here you can see all the pick list values are available. So if you want to show particular field for a particular pick list value for stage, so you can add them from here. So here you can see all the fields available. So let's say I'm choosing description, clicking on save. So this description field will be available when your the chord is having stage pithiest value as prospecting. If we go on need analysis, we can choose any other value. So let's say I'm choosing description as well as I am choosing amount. So these two values will be available when we will be on need analysis. Now I am moving back to prospecting. So here you can see guidance for success. So here you can write some text that will be related to guidance of completion of this stage value. So let's say I am typing guidance one, guidance two. So this is a test data that I'm putting here. You can put as per your requirement of the project or assignment. So this will be available on the record page. So I'm putting this only for prospecting. Now I'm clicking on next. Then first option is when users reach a specific step in the path, help them celebrate their success with on-screen confetti. And second is activate your path. If you aren't ready to make this path available now, you can still save it and activate it later. So I'm activating it as well as I'm activating this also. So I'm choosing three options. So if you want to make some celebration kind of thing, so you can choose particular pick list values. So I'm choosing close one as well. So on these pick list values, a celebration kind of thing will happen. Then here you can, from here you can choose celebration frequency. So rarely, sometimes, often, and always, these are available. So right now I'm choosing always because I want to show you how this takes place. Now I'm clicking on finish. So this will automatically available for your record page because we are having stage pick list as our path. So here you can see it is created for opportunity object and for this record type. So now if I click on save and back, I'm clicking on back and you will see that path will be enabled automatically. So here you can see one accordion is available. If I click on this, I chose two fields, description and amount for this stage. If I go to this stage, so it will show only one field that is description. And here you can see steps are available, guidance for success steps. And if you click on edit, so you can edit the value that is available in the description. So if I put some value, let's say test, so it will be saved and it is available here. If I go to here, so that field value will be available here as well. And if I go to the details of this record, so here you can see it is available. So this way, all these things are interrelated, right? Now, right now we are on need analysis. If I click here and if I click on this mark as current stage, so you can see stage changed successfully and some celebration kind of things are available here. So this way you can do that thing. So I hope you understood how we can set up our path. So it is by default available for a particular pick list. If you want to change that pick list or you want to change some settings, so you can go to path setting. So that you can do by going on edit page as well as you can search here as well. So you can search path setting in the setup. So that will be available directly also. But remember one thing, for one object, for one record type, you can create only one path. So that will be applicable as per the requirement. So you can delete it as well. You can edit it as well. You can deactivate it whenever required. And I hope you understood how we can set up the path through this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you can find various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages. So do watch them. Thank you for watching this video.